January Finance Committee to order. Roll call.
Councilman Kraus.
Here.
Councilwoman Meany.
Here.
Councilman Pedicino.
Here.
Okay, we've got a couple minutes. First, the budget hearing from November 16th.
Okay, I'll go ahead and make a motion to approve the budget hearings of November 16th, 2016.
Second.
Motion second. Any discussion? I'm sure we all read it thoroughly. Roll call.
Councilman Kraus.
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany.
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino.
Yes.
And then our regular meeting from December 19th.
Okay, I'll go ahead and make a motion to approve the minutes of the regular meeting of December 19th, 2016.
Second.
Motion second. Any discussion? Roll call.
Councilman Kraus.
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany.
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino.
Yes.
All right.
Make a quick comment. Yes. I just really want to thank Kim, because this was a lot of
typing. Thank you.
A lot of typing, and it was very, you know.
Thank you.
Like, I'm going to keep this because it kind of shows what we talked about and what we did. So really appreciate you and all the hard work you did, because I'm sure this had to be extremely time consuming for you to do. And I just really want to thank you.
Thank you very much.
Okay, sorry about that, Ed.
I would second that.
Thank you.
All right, we have item one is the request to approve the various fund transfers that we have and the various things that we support in the transfers. It's a memo from Matt to our committee. There's a little over $2.6 million in requested transfers, all from the general fund to the various funds regarding whether it's, you know, economic incentive, there's home days, service safety, capital fund, workers' comp, accumulated sick and leave, and budget stabilization. And the allocation of the resources was all included in the 17 appropriation budget. Matt?
Yes, Councilman Kraus mentioned these were presented during the budget presentation, so this is really the second approval with transfers from the general fund to other funds. We are actually technically getting two approvals. You appropriate the funds, and then we seek approval to actually move the money from the general fund to the funds as highlighted. So that's what we're looking for. Again, looking for first reading adoption as emergency. And I would ask, to make it easy, when you when presenting this to council, I think you can present it as requesting to approve the budget of 2017 transfers rather than going through them line by line. I don't think it's necessary.
Yeah,
but
okay.
And they'll understand it was in the budget that was appropriated and approved. Right. It's the other benefit of adopting the full budget and not doing it temporary. You're only going to see this once at this meeting. And unless there's some sort of change in the budget levels for these transfers, we're not going to come back to Finance Committee or Council for any additional requests for interfund transfers.
And that's because it was included in the budget.
It was we appropriated the full year, yeah. And that was adopted by council.
It's all complete, yeah. So.
Okay. I have one question, just because I to refresh my memory, Matt, with the budget stabilization, which I call the rainy day fund, what are we up to in that fund now?
We're putting half a million in now. We're at 6.2, I believe, and we're going to be at 6.7 with this $500,000.
Okay.
And I think I'm kind of getting ahead to your summary that you're gonna talk about. The amounts that we were under that for the encumbered amounts and some of these accounts, that's going to be rolled over for like future work to be done, like in 2017, for work like for the buildings. And
yeah,
stuff
for
like
some
that.
Of the capital projects, there are some encumbered obligations. So an example would be the roof project here is almost complete, but we've not paid the final bills to the contractors. So that encumbrance carries over to 17, and it's added to the newly appropriated project as well. So there are some obligations that roll. And those are accounted for jumping ahead in the summary of fund balances. When we show you the final balance, that's the unencumbered balance. It's netting out any encumbrances that have carried over from the prior year. So it's the actual available dollars, net of any type of obligation.
Okay. Okay, I make a motion to prepare legislation for council to approve the proposed fund transfers as outlined in Exhibit A, summary of 2017 fund transfer from general funds to the various funds, and declaring an emergency for the various operations to be funded to the operating funds in 2017.
Second.
Motion is second. Any further discussion? Roll call.
Councilman Kraus?
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany?
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino?
Yes.
Okay, next we have the various reports, the financial reports, all from December 2016, that are in our packet. Any comments, questions? Any comment, Matt?
As you noted in the agenda, I labeled these preliminary monthly reports. December is, we're in the process of closing out December. Takes a little bit longer, probably wrap it up into this week. So some of the revenue numbers aren't complete. If you see something that looks lower, most likely it's because we're wrapping up. In fact, from when I compiled these last week until tonight, there's already been updates to revenue because we're wrapping up all our final entries on both the revenue and expenditure side. So this is about 95% complete. And that's why I didn't do a narrative for this set of reports. Our next meeting in February, I'll give you a year-end review, report, final numbers, and some highlights on how we fared budgetarily and all the major funds of the city as well. So this is more or less give you an idea where we stand at this kind of intermediary stage in closing out the year. One note, it looks like we're going to be definitely under budget in general fund by at least $2.5 million on the operating side. The general fund balance looks like it's going to be about $1.5 million higher than we anticipated when we put the budget together, which is good. And that's so right now we're just over $15 million unencumbered in the general fund. Again, that's not a final number on cash basis just yet, but we'll be fairly close to that number.
I think that's kind of what I was getting to too with the budget stabilization fund. It's 5% of the.
We did have, well, we moved, we proposed moving $500,000 in 17 out of the general fund into budget stabilization. And we didn't tie it to a percentage necessarily. It was, came up with an amount that we think we could maintain in the operating picture for 17. 16, there was actually a higher request. We requested to transfer $1 million in 16. So in 2016, we moved $1 million from the general fund to the stabilization fund. So you can see the balance is continuing to accumulate. Now, we talked about, well, during budget hearings, I think one of the questions was, what do we think the right amount should be in that stabilization fund?
Because it's restricted use.
It's restricted use. And I had mentioned maybe $10 million is a good number to shoot for. We also, I think, mentioned a percentage of general fund revenues as well, something we can think about or refine. I think the idea is keep setting some money aside in increments. In 17, we're doing a little bit less, but we're still building, I think, a healthy balance. In the general fund itself, the unencumbered balance in the general fund, regardless of what's in the stabilization fund, you can see we're over 30% balance to expenditure for 2016. So we exceed our policy, and it's a very healthy balance to maintain in the general fund. That's a good thing. Gives us lots of flexibility going forward.
I have one question.
Go ahead, Matt.
Matt, in the, I guess it's page 2 or 3, where you talk about the year-to-date expenditure summary for the capital improvement funds, for the citywide traffic signal improvement, there's no money in that?
That project is in a different fund. It is.
Is that, okay.
It's complete. And that was in, I believe.
No, it isn't, because we haven't given them all the money back.
Yeah, and there's a separate fund, I think 401, where that was actually placed. And then the ongoing maintenance for traffic is in the budget and infrastructure fund in 17 and beyond.
Okay.
So there's nothing left, at least in that fund, for that project. You're referring to Exhibit C, the capital?
Let's see.
What is it?
It's the year to date. It says here page 1 of 3, and then the one I'm talking about is page 2 of 3, and it's a year to date expenditure summary is up on top. So it's after all the revenue summaries.
Yes.
It's the one after that.
Yeah, there's no active appropriation, that's why. I think there may be. I'm not even sure if there's any encumbrances left in that fund as well. It's a question I can follow up on. I believe there was no active current year budget in that fund.
What's the difference between the facility and repair and maintenance, A, 435, and facility repair and maintenance, B, 442.
Yeah, I don't know the backstory why we had two facility maintenance funds. At some point in time, prior to my arrival, we decided to consolidate into one capital fund for facility improvements, and that's 435. Okay. 442 is no longer active. We might have a small balance in there.
Do we generally, is it practice to close those
eventually
out?
Eventually we'll close them. So, for example, in Fund 442, which is B, we have just under $21,000. That may be an example where we would come to committee and council and request to move the money to the 435 fund and then close out that fund if there's really no use for it.
Yeah, because I know we had been attempting for a while to try to close. Like, we have the old City Hall, you know, Fund sure. 476, which I don't think has had any movement in a long time.
Now, and for general capital, as you know, we have three separate funds, which is, I think that's ample. We're tracking by facilities, right. Service and safety and equipment. I think right. that's good.
Okay. I mean, is it best practices to close them out?
Yeah, once we're sure, hey, we don't think we need to have a use to segregate some other type of capital project. I mean, we have discretion. We have steps we have to follow. We have to get approval. Council, we have to move the money, which is a transfer. So if we do close those out, well, there's a set of steps, requirements we have to meet, both per our local ordinances, but also per revised code. And we can do those. But I think there's probably some additional housekeeping we can do on the capital side and eliminate the funds we're not using anymore.
Was that from an auditing standpoint? Is that suggested?
Yeah, it's a good suggestion. It's not required. We do have discretion how many funds we want to maintain. I think there's a good medium, a happy medium as far as how many we want. But yeah, I think we do have some room to probably close those out. I think we're at a good number as far as what we're using to track capital at least.
All right. And lastly, we were going to talk a little bit about the Finance Committee meeting schedule. We've been doing it sort of randomly sometimes, depending on the amount of agenda items.
Mm-hmm.
Some months I know we have combined it on a council meeting date like tonight.
Right.
Sometimes I find that to be helpful if we're all here. Mm-hmm. Matt's here, Kim's here. But I'm open and flexible as to how everyone wants to do it. We can, obviously keep it set,
mm-hmm.
Or we can do it, every month, depending on the, depending on the agenda and how much is on the agenda.
Yeah, and right now, with the timing of the calendar, we're the third Wednesday of the month. So, for example, for this year, excluding January, we have seven additional months where finance is 2 days after the last council meeting.
Right, right.
And the next one's April.
Right.
I'm not recommending we change the standing meeting day, but maybe based on agenda and how we think mm-hmm. Things are going to fall into place, I can send a notice to the committee well in advance. April will be the next example. Right. If the agenda doesn't seem like it's too overwhelming, that'd be an example where we can move from the 19th of April to before the 17th meeting of April. And then the other months are May, June, July, September, October, December. It's the same situation where we have finances 2 days after council
meeting.
Even if we're not asking to have something approved on first reading at the next council meeting as an emergency, and we're sending something for the full three readings, it's still helpful to get that first reading out of the way so we can continue right. moving things along in an expeditious way. So I thought at least mention that so people are mm-hmm. aware. So when April comes around, we have an expectation that I'll reach out and let people know, hey, the agenda looks like it's manageable. Is everyone okay with moving to 6 or 6:30 based on the calendar?
No, that makes sense to me.
Okay.
I mean, I would be agreeable to, like you said, Matt, when it's 2 days after, because then you're waiting a lot of times, almost 2.5 weeks
right.
before
Can
it comes.
Be.
I was thinking too.
Yeah.
So, and we could still consider it case by case, even though I know
right.
we know what those months are. We can take it case by case yeah. each month and yeah. get the word out, let people
okay.
know.
Good. Okay. I'll go ahead and make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Motion second. Roll call.
Councilman Kraus.
Yes.
Councilwoman Meany.
Yes.
Councilman Pedicino.
Yes.
Thanks, everybody.